As you know, we hit 120 degrees.
The hottest day that Las Vegas has ever seen, breaking the all-time record of 117.
There's no doubt about it. It gets hot in the summer in Las Vegas. And with the long-standing record of 117 degrees being completely blown out of the water, we wanted to stop by the National Weather Service to see just how that temperature is taken.
We're setting records, but it's not necessarily ones we want to set. Summer of 2024 will go down as the year that the temperature didn't stop at 117 degrees, or even 118 or 119 degrees. Las Vegas shattered the heat record and hit 120.
So we're outside, it's about 1 p.m., it's 109 degrees, and even the desert landscape can get super hot. I've got a temperature gun, let's go ahead and test it out. So we're standing here over rocks, and the temperature is about 142 degrees.
Prior to 2024, the temperature of 117 has only ever been hit 5 times in Las Vegas. During this historic heat wave, not only did we hit 120, but we hit 117 or greater several times as well, breaking not only the all-time record, but multiple daily records as well. But how is this official temperature taken? The way the temperature is taken is standardized not only across Las Vegas, but across the country so that the numbers can be compared on an even level. It's taken in the shade in a white structure that has air ventilation, and it's placed about 6 feet off the ground over dirt and rocks, not asphalt or concrete. You might think that taking the temperature in the shade isn't representative to how it actually feels in the sun, but this is the way to take the true air temperature and standardize the process. Taking the temperature in the sun introduces too many variables. Factors such as elevation and latitude make the sun's radiation different.
In order to compare apples to apples around the country, around the world, we need to have all the temperatures being taken in the shade, and that creates a level playing field, so to speak.
You might know that the official temperature is taken at the airport, but why? In Las Vegas's case, it's a pretty central location, but there's more to it than that. There's some history behind it. Prior to computers and the technology we have now, someone would have to go out and check the data every hour. The National Weather Service used to be located at what now is Harry Reid International Airport. This was convenient for pilots who could walk into the Weather Service office and request a forecast for their flight. Now there's computers for that.
And then we get that information transmitted to us.
You can actually see the site where all of the data is taken at the airport right from Sunset Road. Each of these mechanisms you see on the map, Dan told us, is measuring something different. On the left are the rain buckets measuring our official rainfall totals. The tall pole measures the wind speed. And the structure towards the middle is for the official temperature.
While it's the official temperature for Las Vegas, it would be impossible to have a single point in the valley be representative of the entire valley.
When looking at temperatures around the valley, you'll notice they vary by several degrees depending on where you are. This is largely in part to elevation differences. Summerlin and Anthem are higher than the rest of the valley, therefore they're a couple degrees cooler. Another factor is the urban heat island, which is not only why our central valley is warmer, but it also contributes to our rising temperatures. And it's not only the hot temperatures that are getting hotter and setting records. Our low temperatures are too. In a normal year, on average, we set or tie about 5 to 10 daily high temperature records, but we haven't set a low temperature record since 1999. This is because due to urban development, the concrete, asphalt, and buildings hold on to heat overnight, so the air isn't able to cool as much as it used to. This is the urban heat island. There's no doubt about it. Our extreme summer heat isn't going anywhere, and the urban heat island is a real issue. The city is doing what it can to curb its effects by planting more trees to provide additional shade in not only our parks, but our urban areas as well. The goal is to plant 60,000 trees by the year 2050. Unlike a storm, the heat may not be visual, but the message from the National Weather Service is, do not underestimate it.
Weather is so important here because heat kills. What kills more people in America than hurricanes or tornadoes? Heat and flooding. It's not pretty. You can take an incredible, dramatic video of a tornado or a hurricane. You can't do that with heat. It's literally this silent killer. With climate change, we're experiencing more extreme weather on both ends of the scale. More warm temperatures, more cold temperatures, more storms, more hurricanes. I believe extreme heat will happen again in our future. To what magnitude, I can't predict at this point.
Hey, so we've got so much more fun and informative content just like this. So if you like this video, you're bound to like these. And while you're at it, don't forget to give this video a like and don't forget to hit that subscribe button.